Alright everyone, welcome to my first episode of my NASCAR Heat 5 modding tutorial series. In this episode I'm going to be showing you guys how to mod in a custom paint scheme. This is probably the most basic thing you can do in NASCAR Heat 5 when it comes to modding. So I'm just going to show you guys where to get the schemes, how to get them in game, what to use to get them in game. So without further ado, let's just get right into it. Alright, so first, this is going to be the website from where you can get basically every single scheme you want. This right here, ozzyconpaints.com. You just go here, you basically get whatever paint scheme you want. They have it, they have everything here. They have 2021 paint schemes, they have 2020 paint schemes. Like, it's just a great website and they're all free. So just go here, get what scheme you want and just download it, and then we're going to go on to the next step. Alright, so for this first episode, we're going to be putting in, let me see here, let's put in this Timmy Hill paint scheme right here, Toyota Timmy Hill paint scheme. Let's replace Bobby Carter with Timmy Hill. So first of all, you have to install this program right here. I'm gonna have a link in the description for it. Unity Asset Bundle Extractor, this one right here. So, first of all, after you install it, first of all, you're gonna have to go right here where it says File, click on Open, and you have to go to where you have your NASCAR Heat 5 game installed. In my case, it's in Local Disk D, on Steam, in Steam Apps, Common, NASCAR Heat 5, NASCAR Heat 5 Data, Streaming Assets, PC, Asset Bundles, and Car Appearances. This is where you have basically every single paint scheme. So, in my case, I want to replace, like I said, I want to replace Bobby Carter. So, I go right here, search for Bobby Carter. This one right here, default C17 Bobby Carter. This is the one. So you want to click on it. And then this thing is going to come up. So every time you open a brand new file, every time you want to edit a new paint scheme that you haven't edited before, this thing is going to pop up. This bundle file is compressed to your original package. You're just gonna have to say yes. Then you go back to your car appearances folder, and you make a brand new text document. You call it whatever you want, it doesn't really matter. You just make a brand new text document in this folder, and you basically just click on it. And it says whatever already exists, you want to replace it, you click yes. That will basically open up the file in Unity Asset Bundle Extractor to allow you to edit it. So, you go to Info, and you look for the file that says Paint Job here at the end. You click on it, you go to Plugins, click Edit, OK, and then you go to right here where it says Load, go to Paint Schemes, and basically just select the paint scheme you want to get. So in my case, it's this Timmy Hill paint scheme right here. Click OK. Click OK again. Would you like to save your changes? Press yes, of course. Go to File, press Save, go back to Car Appearances, go back here where it says Search, search for Bobby Carter, whatever driver you're wanting to replace. Click the file you opened just once, so you get the name in here where it says File Name. You go back to Car Appearances, and you add something right before this dot here. I'm just gonna add the one. And then you can click Save. After this, you can just exit out of Unity Asset Bundle Extractor. Then you go to your Car Appearances folder. Usually, when you go to Car Appearances, this is how your folder is going to look like. You just want to press on Date right here. So it shows you the file you just most recently edited. In our case, it's this Bobby Carter file. And then I'm just going to click on it. I'm going to click on Name, so I can more easily find the original one, which is right here. Then I'm going to just delete it and rename the one we just edited by removing whatever you added before the dot. In my case, it was the one. So I'm just going to remove that. And after this, you can go in game, and if you did everything right, it should work. So we're just going to go in game now and see if it worked. Alright, so we're in game now. Let's just skip over this intro here. As you can see, my game is pretty modded. I also have a custom title screen, which I can show you guys in like a miscellaneous modding episode if you guys would like that. It's not that hard to actually change. We're just gonna go to race now. Let me just plug in my controller real quick. Okay, so as you can see, we have a bunch of schemes already. Here's Bubba Wallace. Have all of his schemes. Daniel Suarez. I'm not actually sure where it is. Wait a second here. There it is. I know it has Ty Dillon's picture. Just ignore that. Here he is. This is Timmy Hill. As you can see, it works perfectly fine. The scheme looks pretty good. It's Timmy Hill's Toyota, so it works. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it helped you out. In my next episode, I'm going to show you guys how to replace drivers in-game. For example, if I want to get Noah Gragson, I know it's not actually his scheme, but as you can see, it says Noah Gragson. So if you want me guys to show you how to replace the driver in-game, that can be the next episode. And if you guys need help with anything, you can contact me on Twitter or just leave a comment in the description. So I hope to, like I said, I hope I helped you guys out, and I'll see you guys next time.